Okay, good morning everyone. So today we are discussing about purchase specification and maintenance of store for raw materials from the quality control and quality assurance chapter 3, the first topics. So let's see. So what we will be seeing that content is purchase specification, maintenance of stores, selection of vendors, and control of raw material from finished dosage forms that we are going to see in the upcoming slides. So first we have to know that what are the raw materials, like what is raw materials. So all the materials that use into the manufacturing of the finished bulk, even though it may or may not present in the final products, are certain solvent like which are the consumed by the persons using it are called as raw materials. Means they are the materials which are used also. Written like it is the operation features and other characteristics that quality and quantify the purchase required. That are the specifications. Different mode of purchase anything by brand, by grades. And what are the purchases? Like used during the purchase procedures, we can see that purchase requests, selection to select the supplies from which supplier will be goods, and in the materials, checking up in bills. And recording our bills in books, releasing the payment of supplier, all these things during the purchasing. And the throughput of the product class. Mr. Staff involved in the purchasing, they must have the knowledge about the products and the supplier. The supplier which supply the product have that has the products. And Ramya can purchase from the supplier name in the are derived from the process. Specification starts by manufacturing for starting materials we discuss with the suppliers, and the specification which are established by the manufacturer that must be discussed with the suppliers. Pharmacists and chemist who is familiar with the requirement of various material process department can have be the head of the department, and the pharmacists are have knowledge of the quality required of process materials. And storage, what is the specification for the storage area materials? What are the options of skin print and sampling areas? All these are waiting and segregation for the storage of waitings. Segregation for the storage of reject, recall, or return materials. Safe and secure area for narcotic and highly active, dangerous, and risky materials. All these things should be maintained during the storage of raw materials. And the one that formula will flow mainly follow in industries, FIFO and FEFO. FIFO means first in, first out rules, and first expire, first out rules. This should be flow during the storage of raw materials and using for the manufacturing. And maintenance of the storage. Storage condition. What is the condition required for the storage of raw materials? Room temperature should be 30 degrees Celsius and relative humidity should be 60%. And if it is AC storage, then it should be 25 plus or minus 2 degree and relative humidity should be 45 to 55 degrees Celsius. And the low temperature storage is 2 to 8 degrees Celsius. If there any product which is, should be stored in low temperature, then it should be temperature of 2 to 8 degrees Celsius. And temperature for the sterile products, that should be stored in AC condition. And light sensitive materials in amber color containers, hermetically sealed containers, and labeling of the materials in the storage area. designated name and product and internal code reference that should be kept on the materials which is storage. Batch number given by the suppliers. The batch number which is given by supplier that should be stick on the products. Status of the content. What is the like product names or what types of product is kept inside the containers. Expiry date or date beyond with the restriction of necessary. All these things should be mentioned in the product during the storage conditions. And during the fully computerized system use, labeling with all above information need to be necessary and the check the list before the storage. Like integrity of the packaging and seals, correspondence note for the orders, delivery and supply level. All these things should be checked during before the storage of the raw materials. And the check list during storage condition, we have to check that separation of the reject materials, recall, quarantines and the test and packaging materials, quality of the materials, released by QC and QC department. The material should be released by QC and QC departments only. And now we have to see the selection of vendors. Like how you select the vendors. And the following process components should be studied with the suppliers or manufacturers, like study of suppliers manufacturing process, product specifications and evolutions, process evolutions, process and specification change, process and specification change in control systems, carrier out and represent formal technical audit report of vendors. Base of the audit and finding vendors can be certified or decertified. All these things we have to see during that order or during selection of the vendors. So next we'll see the classification of vendor. How we'll classify the vendors based upon the different criteria and different things we'll classify the vendors. So selection of the customer teams to define the objective and the potential benefits, like supplier selections, initial supplier contacts, process element, in process element again three types, like supplier process specification and process evolutions, process and specification change, customer specifications, all these things based on quantity based
then are we stored as the sample should be recharged
collecting of the samples. Following the consideration likeliness of the will go for and materials. And SOP with Phoenix batch number of time is how they are and which and